makes its way up to the line, goes forward. So the red light is now blinking. We're ready. They're off and racing. Diplomat Express bounced first, headed though by San Crispino. Western Star starts to whip over now, and so does Mekong Den, and going forward, Magic Las Vegas as they settle down. And further back is Merivale Miss on the outside of Plead. The fifth, Pike, was able to park the favourite behind them, Delta Bill, with three behind it, Test of Strength and Altamont. And back last of all is Black Attack. And so they leave the straight behind them over the crossing, 1,600 to travel. And the early leader is Mekong Den, three quarters Western Star. Magic Las Vegas just wants to race a bit keenly back behind them, a length and a half away. A similar gap to Diplomat Express, and then came San Crispino, one to Plead, the fifth, and a similar margin, Merivale Miss, as the field starts to string. A length and a half to Delta Bell, racing on the outside from Test of Strength, and the last couple, Altamont, who's back there with Black Attack. Mekong Den goes up on the inside once again when challenged there fleetingly by Western Star, but it was able to hold the front, Mekong Den. Western Star sits a neck away, running second, and then two lengths behind them came Magic Las Vegas. Further back on the rails there with the pink cap is Diplomat Express, being covered by San Crispino. Plead the fifth over on the inside is next of all, three quarters to Merivale Miss. Test of Strength is over on the rails. Pike quite happy to be back there, biding his time with the filly Delta Bell. And over on the inside, Black Attack is second from last in front of Altamont. There's been no change to the order. Mekong Den on the inside, still with that narrow lead at the 650. From on the outside, Western Star, who now goes up and gets on square terms. A length and a half away behind them to Magic Las Vegas. It's had a cozy run for Bennett. On the fence behind them to Diplomat Express. They're being followed further back by Merivale Miss and San Crispino. As they come into the home straight, Delta Bell's going to be right off the track, but that's where the better going's been pretty much all day. Into the straight they fan. Western Star reached the lead. San Crispino challenging it. Merivale Miss. Here comes the baldy face Delta Bell down the outside, getting a run on the inside of those. Towards the insiders, Magic Las Vegas. Delta Bell at the 100, ranged up. Merivale Miss going with it though. Merivale Miss, Delta Bell. Delta Bell gets the head in front of the shadows and the bob. Thought she might have just got there. Delta Bell for Merivale Miss. Behind them in third spot, Magic Las Vegas from San Crispino. And then deeper out was Plead the fifth, followed then by Diplomat Express, Western Star. It dropped out. Further back in the field, Altamont, followed home by Black Attack. And after leading, Mekong Den compounded to run second last in front of Test of Strength. Number seven, Delta Bell, ridden by William Pike to give him the second leg of a double for the day. And she puts together two successive victories. Animal Kingdom filly, she was off the track, but she got, I thought, and I think most would probably attest to, the better part of the ground here this afternoon. And she finished off well for Team Williams and Peter's Investments. From Merivale Miss, who battled hard. And then back towards the inside, also boxing on, was Magic Las Vegas in front of 10 San Crispino. 7-8-1-10, the placings. Delta Bell by Animal Kingdom from Petite Bell. William Pike. Saluting from Merivale Miss, the Blackfriars Mare, trained by Ross Price and ridden by Kate Whitten, and Magic Las Vegas by Trade Fair, Christy Bennett for Paul Jordan. 7-8-1-10, the numbers. Short neck, 1.25 margins in 2.16.40. The last, the Furphy Handicap, over 1,300 at 4:45. Stephen Parnham's the new rider for 7, Scandal Maker, replacing Craig Staples, who, if you've just joined us, was involved in a fall, a nasty one earlier on in the day in the two-year-old race, and has a suspected broken wrist, as I understand. So we'll get a bit more detail, though. It's either a broken wrist or a fractured right arm, one or the other. I've heard conflicting reports at this particular stage. The sectional is 36-3-0 there after the victory of Delta Bell, who was taken out of the feature race on the weekend, reserved for this there. She would have been competitive in a race like that. Let's go down. Here's Mark.
Yeah, thanks, Darren, with Bob Peters, and pretty good performance. Were you always confident she'd get there?
Well, I was hoping she'd get there. On her last run, I would have expected her, or hope, you know, that she could have won easily, but she didn't, did she?
No, she didn't, but she did get there eventually. She was scratched on Saturday for the Belmont Classic. What was the thought in that? Was it your thought that she'd probably run second to the stable, mate, or did you think she might not be necessarily up to that level?
No, I was just worried that if she had have been placed, she would have thrown away a lot of races. you know, she's eligible for West Speed, and I think she was only a 58 rater. If she'd have even run a place, she would have been up, you know, 66 or 7 or 8 or something. If she'd won, she would have been well over that. So it just wasn't worth it.
What's the plan for her now? She obviously gets over ground. That's 2,100 metres today. What do you see doing with her in maybe the next campaign, perhaps?
Oh, well, there'll probably be another race over this sort of distance shortly, so she can keep going.
Just a word on Williams' achievement on the weekend, up to 227 winners now for the season. It's just remarkable, isn't it?
Yes, he's doing a great job.
Well, he certainly is, and he's got the cattle to do it as well. Congratulations, Bob.
Yeah, thank you.
Bob Peters there, the breeder and the owner of the winning horse here in Delta Bell. She came out of that race on Saturday to go around in this. Bob, you just heard say, was concerned about what ratings points she'd cop for winning such a race, but she won this quite impressively in the end.
Yeah, absolutely. Looks an out-and-out stayer as well, doesn't she? She really used that turn of foot late over the last 400 metres, but really put her in just a sleep for the first half of the race or so and started to make his move just coming into the turn.
Yeah, she was in the autumn sale here in Perth earlier this year. She was withdrawn from that sale. I know there was a few people had her eye on her trying to get her for a reasonable sum of money, and they're probably a little bit upset at seeing how well she won today.
Well, exactly right. But no surprise, obviously, they had something there in the tank, and the way that she won last start at Pinjarra over the 2,000 metres just suggests that she's got bigger and better things. But here comes Willie Pike just weighing in after that victory there on Delta Bell. He's now got two victories for the day. Willie, that was obviously a really nice performance there over the last couple of hundred metres.
It was an okay performance. I think everyone was probably expecting it to do a little bit easier. I still think it had good merit because she got a bit disunited on the bend and was really struggling. So to actually still pick up after that is a really good effort.
Do you think that was more tempo related up front?
Not really. I think, actually, I'm not sure what it was, to tell you the truth, but last time down on the fence, softer run, she enjoyed that. Today I sort of just out a bit wider and might have been out of her comfort zone as had.
Sure thing, and you've got Bushfire Blonde there in the last. Can we back Pike and drink what we like after the last race?
I sure hope so. I've won on him before, so never say never.
Sounds good. All the best, Willie.
Thank you.
Champion jockey there, William Pike. 2.27 for the season now for the Wizard. We're going to take a break on Thoroughbred Central. After that, a feature on the recently retired jockey, Jeff Lloyd.